This is Ina Garten's go-to dinners. You can see here what it looks like in total. Lots of awesome recipes and photos. As you can see, I love how photogenic everything is in here. That's why my lights turned down, because I need you guys to see how cool it is. All right, so here is our table of contents. So beautiful Ina right there. So here we go. Drinks and apps, breakfast for dinner. Yes, light dinners, family dinners, vegetables and sides, desserts. So that's pretty simple. Here are some recipes. Already I'm loving her. She's like, let's have a pink grape for Paloma for breakfast. Perfect. So here we go. We have a pomegranate spritzer even. I like that there's drinks sprinkled throughout. Love that. Okay, so we have an antipasto board. That looks stunning. I wish I could do a board like that. Here we have a, this looks like an avocado toast, but elevated. So here, I'll break some of these down for you. This is an overnight Irish oatmeal. So you'll see here we have our list of ingredients, and then we have our directions. On the very, very bottom, it says make ahead. So I'm wondering if every recipe has a little tiny, no, not every single one, but some of them do have extra tips on the bottom or trickle throughout. We also have in the very top just some, you know, information about where this recipe comes from, or sides, or, you know, some other information about it, maybe alternatives. This is a croissant with smoked salmon. That looks amazing. This is a blueberry ricotta breakfast cake. Yum. Oh, man, I had lunch not too long ago. This is a homemade chicken stock. Beautiful. I personally would love, I need to work on my stock and soup based game, especially when fall comes back. I know we're just hitting spring and summer, but I noticed that's something I need to work on. Here we have lobster and avocado sandwiches. That looks really great and is probably very tasty for spring, summertime. If you go on hikes, you can pack one with you. Here is a hot dog and a puff pastry. That would be good. I'm sure the kids would love that one. We have warm vegetable and grain bowl. Vibrant, very colorful. Creamy eggs with lobster and crab. Wow. I don't know how I feel about creamy eggs. I'd probably try it. We have a Provençal orange salad. Interesting. I have a feeling that it's gonna be really great for summertime. The beginning of some of these chapters, you'll see a list of all of the recipes that will be featured, which is handy. So it'd be great if you are trying to plan a whole table setting and you can kind of pick throughout this one cookbook and figure out exactly where everything goes. So that looks like a worm to me originally, but this is a Hasselbeck kielbasa, and I hope they have like this whole tray bake recipe. It looks really good. Here is an oven roasted southern shrimp boil. Again, all of these are perfect for summertime. I'm really glad I picked it up now, now, so that I am prepared for summertime get-togethers. Lemon linguine with zucchini and basil. Ooh, that's a good idea. Orange marmalade ham. Here's vegetables and sides. Already, I love the asparagus. I know it's simple, but ooh, whoa. So balsamic roasted baby peppers. A very, very easy recipes all throughout. Even some of those larger recipes we saw. These molasses baked beans. All of these are very simple, easy to make. This is the maple roasted honey nut squash. 5 ingredients. That's it. And you just throw it in the oven and let it do its thing. Garlic roasted haricots, verts, green beans. French string beans. We even have desserts. Of course, I flipped through this so fast because I was eager for the dessert chapter. Here we have them, their family. Here's the panettone bread pudding. I love bread pudding. I wish I could have it. So there is no gluten-free alternatives I have seen in this book, or vegan. So you're gonna have, if you wanna use this cookbook, you'll have to find substitutes or use your intuition. Here's vanilla pound cake, a very simple recipe. Ooh, different toppings for your pound cake. This is a rum raisin ricotta ice cream. I don't think I've actually ever had rum raisin ice cream or rum raisin anything. And now I'm thinking I should. It's a popular flavor. Chocolate buttercream. So you can mix and match some of these recipes together, especially these desserts like the whipped cream. And we have extra resources, so that's really nice that they've provided that. So if you are looking for a really easy weekday meal, go to dinner. This is perfect. You can also find our playlist of easy, quick and easy cookbooks that are listed over here. And make sure to join us on our socials. You'll find that in the description down below. Hopefully you'll keep watching and you'll find that cookbook that you've always wanted. Thanks so much.